So 343 decided to bring this mode back. That mode, Stockpile, but this time it's back in the Combat Workshop. A lot of things have been redone and reworked when it comes to this mode. So I wanted to jump in, try it out, and see how it plays, because Stockpile is probably the least liked mode in Halo Infinite, especially for the BTB playlist, just because it just played so awkwardly and I didn't really enjoy it that much. It seems like things have changed a lot with it, and we're gonna cover that in this video and kind of see how different the Stockpile play out, because previously I was just not a fan of it, man. I did not like it one bit, and I'm getting zapped by a guy with a shock. Please just leave me, let me live. No! So one thing you probably noticed right at the beginning of this game here, just by itself, that the seeds are more spread out on the map, because before they would just spawn in a gigantic pile, and honestly it would just kind of create a cluster of people just kind of huddling around the center of wherever the cluster was, and then it would just be kind of just like almost like little league soccer, right? Just watching a bunch of kids just like kick a ball around, but they're all just huddled around the center point. It wasn't really the most fun thing to do. Also, this time we're playing with bandit rifle starts compared to, I think, when this was last in the game, we had like assault rifle sidekicks. The more I get to play with the bandit rifle, the more I'm starting to like it, which seems like I might have to start liking the bandit rifle a bit more if you're a ranked fan. You can see at the bottom of the screen, you only need 3 seeds to actually make a score compared to previously where you needed 5, which I think this will help kind of increase the pace of the game a little bit. And a big thing, like I said, they're a little more spaced out, so it's not all just consolidated into one location. And so then you actually can play the objective like I just did, and, you know, well, play the game logically, I guess is the way to best put it. There were also less seeds on the map. And a really great thing is that they allow players to utilize equipment now while carrying a seed. All right, the montage spot. Here we go, guys. There's one. Where's two? This is the montage spot. Oh my gosh, maybe not. Maybe not for me. Now, the interesting thing is on the Combat Workshop, which means that you'll have a chance to provide feedback on the mode itself, and you can actually fill out a survey at the end of the whole thing, letting 343 know what you liked or disliked about the mode. Which I'd say any opportunity for fan feedback is always welcomed. And you're not carrying that seed, buddy. Oh, there we go. A nice little shot right at the last second to get the kill. Oh, another one. Oh my god, this is the montage, but I'm on a kill frenzy right now. This is such a cheese spot. I love it, especially with the shock rifle spawning right there. Like, I never have to leave the spot, dude. It's really nice. Oh my god, that guy had a sword and didn't kill me with it. How did that happen? Oh, there we go. Get the stalker rifle guy out of here. Another one too? Why not? Oh god. The objective's right there. But another shock rifle's about to spawn up. Oh, he's got it. Yeah, see, he's got it. We're good. Yeah, I don't need to bother, man. We're fine. I don't need to play selfishly and just go for kills. See, look, I'm benefiting the objective player right there, right? It's not all just about kills. They're strategically located for the kills. That's a running riot. I like that. Oh, gotta try and get spicy with me. I didn't like it. Teammates, why? Oh my god, he's got all the seeds in the back of his truck. No! Oh, they just tied it up right there. I completely forgot about that usefulness of the Razorback on this mode. Like, one guy can score 2/3 of all the points needed, which is gonna be very useful now. No, dude, I'm like one kill off of running right now. Get out of the Haug. I'm driving it now. Get out, I'm out. Go over. No! I tried to throw him off the edge, dude. No. The battle rifle's too good, man. The battle rifle is too good. Best weapon in the game for that. There's a new stock rifle. There we go. We got 3. I'm actually glad that 343 brought this mode back. I just felt like there was something there that could be fun and unique to Halo. The one thing I want to try out is trying to steal a seed. Apparently, the time it takes to steal a seed has been decreased, so you can take them a lot faster now, which is something that I think is huge for the mode. I think that dynamic of being able to steal a seed is really important for the gameplay mechanics of this game, the mode, to really feel like more unique and kind of stand out. Because I feel like with every Halo mode, that like once you score, that's like final, right? But it'd be cool to see if they can find a way to make the stealing mechanic more viable. Oh! I mean, I might miss a couple shots there, but I still got the no scope, baby. And also, Big Team Battle just needed an extra mode in there in the mix because, well, you know, Slayer is great, Capture Flying is great. I love Total Control. It's probably my favorite mode within Big Team Battle. It's just that you only have those three modes on four maps. It just gets repetitive really quick. So any form of more content for this, for Big Team Battle in particular, is greatly appreciated. As we started out kind of hot, and then now we're getting kind of cold. I'm trying to mix it up a little bit here. It's great. Let's go on to the Warhog. I usually don't do this. This is kind of like my number one rule when it comes to playing Halo. You never jump into a random Warhog because you never know what you're going to get. But hopefully it's something. We got a double kill at least. That's good. This guy actually seems to kind of know what he's doing when it comes to driving. Normally what people do is just people just grab a Warhog, grab it into the enemy team's base, and then we all get dominated because there's like 20 people in the back of the map. Looks like things are kind of a little different this time around. Looks like they're actually waiting for me to like have a chance to get kills, which is fantastic. This is probably one of the best random Warhog runs I've ever had, which is really cool. Utilizing vehicles in Halo is crucial, especially in Big Team Battle, that if you find a way to be able to utilize your Warhogs properly, it can be an unstoppable force, but you need to be able to be smart with your usage of vehicles. You can't just run out in the open and blow things up and expect to win the game. It just doesn't really work like that. And well, looks like my teammates are actually kind of like keeping the front line, helping my team push forward, because that's kind of what vehicles really do best, is help support the infantry in pushing forward. If you just kind of ram your vehicle up the middle and push it into the base, you're just gonna get swarmed and everyone's gonna die, and it was a waste of a vehicle, which is always super sad within a Halo match. So I kind of wish this guy was a little more aggressive, or at least moved around a little bit more rather than kind of just standing out in the open in the middle of the map. But hey, what am I doing? I'm not the driver. I'm just a shooter, man. I just shoot things in this game. Oh God!